Okay, well, we are going to start with this two question with the homework, simple homework, very easy homework. Okay, Berito, ready?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, go.
Did you go to the beach on weekend?
Let's see. No, no, I didn't because I stay at home. I was doing some homeworks. I was cleaning, well, I was doing some household chores, tareas del hogar. For example, I was cleaning up my room. I was washing my car. I was doing the laundry. I was preparing a special meal because I was celebrating my father's birthday. And you, Berito, did you go to the beach last weekend?
Yes, I went with my friend. The tour was shoulder. I went beach with my friend. The tours was shoulder for 5 a.m. We went by bus. I bought a boating suit. I bought a soup cream. We really enjoy the sand and the wave of the sea. Also, we went to the release. It is such a beautiful thing to have something so small and fragile in your hands. We prepare lunch, fried fish and ceviche to drink soda with a lot of ice. It was very nice to see the star on the beach and spend a very different night. At night dinner, we ate pupusas to drink coffee. We returned Sunday afternoon at 6 p.m. It was a very nice trip. Finish.
Okay, thank you. Question number two.
Which country do you prefer if you have the opportunity to travel?
I got many options, but my option number one, totally 100% Colombia. I would like to go to Colombia because I saw a soap opera on television that was called Ugly Betty, and Cartagena de Indias catch my attention because it looks very nice and beautiful. And of course, I love to visit beaches. And my option number two, maybe I would like to go again to Argentina. I was visiting Argentina in 2006, so it was a really good experience. I like the people, I like the food, I like the culture, but I would like to go to the Rio de Plata. It looks really amazing, and I would like to go again. And you, Berito, if you had the opportunity to travel, which country would you like to visit?
One country I would like to travel, Australia, to know kangaroos and koalas, because it's something I be always wanted. With half my heart, I went. It also know the culture and language of that country. Also they Australia food, know the beach of the three countries, know the money on the that country. The beach of that country, not the money of that country, travel by plane, planet for 12 hours, make the layover at United States. It's a dream that I wish world came to finish.
Okay, some details. Be careful with the pronunciation. Okay, Benito, thank you. Okay. Hazel, are you ready? Thank you, Hazel. You ready, please? 5, 4, 3, 2, Hazel, yes, ready. Hazel Martinez, 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, I don't know what happened with you. Yes, are you ready or not?
Yes.
Uy, hija linda, pero el micrófono se te escucha bien lejos.
Y ahora.
Ok, practiquemos, porfa. 1, 2, probando sonido. Sí, apégate más al micrófono. Ok, Hazel, please. Question number one, quickly.
How do you feel right now?
Excuse me?
How do you feel right now?
Ah, ok. Well, right now, I feel normal. Today, I had a normal day. I start my work day at 7 a.m. and I was preparing classes. I was having my meals and it was a really good day, a normal day. And how I feel? I feel good. Thank you. What about you?
Hey, teacher. I feel right now tired because today go the school
remember you can invent, okay?
¿Cómo se dice todo el día?
Every day, mi amor, tenemos problemas de audios. Acércate, thank you.
Every day.
Okay, please be responsible with your homework. Question number two.
Question number one is
yes, question one, we already done it. So question number two.
What do you do right now?
Okay, right now I'm teaching English. I'm in class with my students. So it's a routine because I always have classes from 4 a.m. to 8. Most of the time, well, from Monday and Fridays, I work from 4 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. But Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, I work from p.m. to 8 p.m. So it's a routine. So right now, I'm teaching English, and right now, I'm having a conversation with you. And you, Hazel, what are you doing right now?
Right now,
Ahí podemos utilizar el verbo tomar, taking. I'm taking.
Right now I'm taking in class.
Right now I'm taking English classes.
Right now I'm taking English class with my teacher.
Okay, thank you, Hazel. Mi amor, no nos preparamos, Bea. ¿Qué sí, nos pasó? Teacher. ¿Y qué nos pasó?
Dije, no sé, nerviosa.
No, mi amor, no tenés que poner nerviosa. Aquí todos estamos aprendiendo. Así que don't worry about it. Don't chicken out. Okay, I'm going to continue with my third student, Neri. Good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
Do you do your homework?
Yes.
Excellent. Thank you. Se prepara Naomi. Okay, Neri, please. Question number one.
Number one, teacher. What do you think of as your student?
Well, that's a very good question. Nobody asked me before that question. That's a very good question and difficult question. Well, I got many, many groups, Neri, and I got different students. I consider all my students are intelligent, but what's the problem? Some students, I'm talking in general. For example, I got some teenagers that they don't work, but they got a lot of homeworks from schools. And there is another part of students that they are adults. Maybe they are not studying, but they work a lot. And I know they got many responsibilities too. So I got different students, but I love the responsible students. And when I got some students that can be a kind of lazy, I need to switch into teacher, into mother. Because I need to, okay, I'm going to send a message to Chepito, for example, because he's taking back. O sea, se me está quedando atrás. He's taking back.
Yes.
So I need to push it him. But I got some students that they don't need to push it out. So I got different students, but in my personal opinion, the oldest student that I had in all my entire teaching life, she is 67. No, she is 70 years old. Can you believe it? Yes,
wow.
She's 70 years old. She's the oldest in my class. But I love because she said, teacher, I know I'm an old woman, but I want to learn more because I have the time. So she's learning English. Can you believe it? 70 years old. Of course, the methodology is totally different, right? The methodology is totally different. But I love my students. Obviously, I always say my students are a blessing in my life. It's not a job. For me, my vocation, my job is a vocation. It's not a job. That's a good question.
Yes.
Hey, Neri, what do you think about your teacher?
Yes. Oh, my teacher. My teacher is you have a patience.
Uh-huh.
And you are very professional.
Okay.
You have a lot of empathy.
Yes.
In my opinion, I like my teacher.
Oh, thank you. And what's your opinion about your in this case, about your partners? Classmates?
In my opinion, we are persevering.
Uh-huh, perseverant.
It's in general, it's in...
The comment is like, general.
Yes, we like the English class. I try and understand every day the lesson.
Uh-huh.
We like challenges.
Uh-huh, the challenge.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Is English a challenge for you?
Yes, for me, yes.
I remember when you were in the level number 2 or 3, and that at that moment you feel uncomfortable and nervous a lot. I remember that.
Yeah.
Right now,
I remember.
Uh huh.
I remember nervous.
Yes. What about now? How do you feel?
It's
more comfortable.
Yes, more comfortable.
Okay.
In general, in general, level 7 student, we are good student.
Yes, you are. Of course, yes, you are. Can you please, Neri, as a student, would you like to give me to me an advice to improve as a teacher? Any recommendation in class?
In my opinion, is a la recommendation is for mm-hmm. me is mm-hmm. is a is ¿cómo se dice ser?
To be? Ajá, yes, to be.
To be perseverant.
Ah, is okay.
Is teacher is a very professional, is very good.
Okay, no, thank you so much. So next week, well, this is a comment. Next week, Neri, I'm going to start with a new level, level 1. I'm afraid. Can you believe it? I'm afraid. Because all the students, mm-hmm. they don't have any knowledge. No tienen nada de conocimiento en inglés. So I'm afraid because when someone doesn't have any knowledge about English, I need to push it more. Mm-hmm. And I need to push it myself as a teacher. So I got different students. For example, the oldest is 60. The oldest is 55. The youngest is 13. Look at the difference. 55, 13. One is a teenager and the another one is an adult. So it's a challenge. It's a challenge for me. And I'm going to have different students for this level, but I trust in myself. I can do it. Pero sí, I feel a kind of nervous. Sí, me siento un poquito nerviosa. I don't know why. It's a new level. That, siempre he tenido niveles uno, pero en este caso, for this specific situation, I feel nervous. Yes, I feel nervous. And a kind of stress. You know what I mean, right? Your friend is in this level. So I'm so happy. I'm so happy for all my new students, but I feel nervous and a kind of stressful. No, wow. Pero lo sé que lo vamos a lograr. Sé, yes, si Berito lo logró.
Sí.
Con Berito, yes. ¿Te acordaste, Berito?
Sí, sí. Me ha costado mucho. Ha sido un esfuerzo muy grande.
No, yo le con Berito.
Teacher, le confieso, le confieso que con usted empecé a aprender el inglés.
No,
no sabía nada. Vaya, no sabía nada de inglés, así que muchas gracias.
No,
usted es la mejor, la mejor.
No, y a veces me daban ganas de entrar ahí en Zoom y darle un medio ahí a la Berito, ¿verdad? Porque yo decía, ay, Berito. Y ya por fin, yo siento que en nivel 6 la Berito ya despertó, sentí yo. No, pero en serio, gracias, de verdad. Perdón ahí a todos los que he dejado ahí y no me vayan a dormir, ¿ok? Uy, ¿quién levantó la mano? No vi quién levantó la mano. Espérenme que tengo alguien con la levanta. Sí, a favor.
Dice. Era un aplauso.
Oh, okay. Ok, no, miren.
For you, teacher.
No, thank you. Miren, así es, solo a ustedes les voy a contar. Sí, en forma personal, el día martes inicio nivel 1, pero a la teacher se le ocurrió promocionar la academia para gente que tuviera cero conocimiento. Y es increíble que todavía hayan personas que no saben ni los colores, ¿verdad? Entonces ustedes saben que a mí me gusta explotar la conversación, entonces, pero yo sé que con ellos no voy a lograr eso en los 3 meses. Entonces este es un reto para mí porque toda la gente se inscribe a la academia porque quieren hablarlo, ¿verdad? Entonces, y otro error que por decirlo así que cometí fue que se me ocurrió meter a una teenager. Tengo una niña de 13 años, entonces tengo que jugar con eso también de las edades, ¿verdad? Pero espero que todo salga bien y pues igual, ¿verdad? Sí, a manera aparte, pido que siempre ahí me lleven en sus oraciones para que todo salga bien. Yo oro por ustedes también para que todo les vaya bien a cada uno en su vida. No era el tema, pero Neri ahí. Yes, Neri.
We are done for you.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. Ok, ya miren, no quiero llorar, en serio. Ay.
No va a llorar porque la segunda pregunta es, la segunda pregunta es esto.
Ah, bueno, ok, démosle.
You are happy, teacher?
Yes, I am. I wanna cry. Eddie,
my question.
Really? Oh my God, no, don't kidding, my goodness.
Sorry, okay, okay. Sorry.
My okay, let's another see my question. My camera, no problem, is closed, right? Let's see. Yes, my camera is closed. Okay, well, I'm happy. I'm a really happy woman. Number one, because my family is healthy, my parents are healthy too. I got a very amazing brothers, well, older than me, but I love my family. I feel I'm a blessing woman. I enjoy my job. As I said before, it's not a job for me, it's a vocation. I have been teaching English for 10 years. Ooh, I was my first, wow, experience. Yes, my first experience when was I 25 years old. And I love the teaching area. I don't want to work in a call center. I don't want to work in the airport. I don't want to work in another place. So for me, it's a blessing. So I feel happy because my family is okay. That is a big blessing, right? When your family is okay, you're happy. So what about you, Neri? Are you a happy woman?
Yes. Yes, I am. Because, mm-hmm, because God loves me.
Mm-hmm.
I have healthy, I have health,
I'm healthy.
My family, I'm unhealthy,
mm-hmm,
my family too, I have work,
that is I a blessing, yes,
I can pay my bills,
uh-huh,
I enjoy every moment of my life.
Excellent. Hey, according to Neri, to have a job is a blessing in our days. Yes. So to have a job is a blessing. And
for my, for ¿cómo se dice? Por mi edad?
For my age?
For my age is a blessing in the country.
But you're young. You look young, yes, in the pictures. Yes, you're young. Don't kidding.
Oh, thank you.
Yes, you're young in the picture. I say in the picture because I don't have the opportunity to meet in person, right? But maybe in the future, I hope so, okay? when I got my visa, I will visit you, Neri. It's a promise, okay? Bueno, sí, mi visa también, pero no voy a llegar ahí. Mira, aquí vengo.
Okay. Bienvenida, bienvenida.
No, thank you so much. Okay, nice questions. Thank you, Neri. Okay, volunteer. No, I say Naomi, right? I say Naomi.
Later, me.
Okay, later. Thank you. I'm going to say Naomi, porque había dicho con Naomi. Okay, Naomi number one, Alessandro, de ahí sigo contigo. Okay, Naomi, please. Question one.
Okay, my number one, what did you do today?
Ooh, today I did many things. Let's see. In the morning, well, I got up at 6:30 a.m. I went to the park with my dog. Well, I always go to the park with my dog. And when I came back to home, I had my breakfast around 8:30, 9 or 9 a.m. in the morning, obviously. And then I take a break. I saw a movie, a Disney movie. Then I start my work day at 11:30. And then I was having my lunch at 1:30 p.m. and then I continue working, and at 5 p.m. I got my first class. At 4 p.m. I got my first class, then I got my second class, and right now I'm having the third class and the last one. So my idea is I'm going to go to my bed around 10 p.m. maybe, I don't know. because I need to study for my driving test. So what about you, Naomi? What did you do today?
Well, today my I finish all the homework for this week, and I study for the test. Then I slept for a while, and when I got up, I cleaned and took a shower.
Mm-hmm.
Then when my mom came home from work, we watched a movie, so I feel calm today.
Okay, nice. Te felicito, okay, hija.
My question...
Perdón, estás usando todos los...
Number two is, what...
Perdón.
What,
uy, uy, uy.
Are you going to
me
eat
escuchan, hijo, for sí. Dinner? Me escuchan, uno, yes. Dos, tres. Ah, okay. Perdón, hija linda, te decía que te felicito porque estás utilizando todo en pasado. Muy bien. Perdón, pregunta número dos, Naomi. Uy, pues no, yo creo que Naomi es la que tiene el falso ahí. Quiero ver, Naomi.
Nosotros sí le escuchamos. Sí,
sí. Sí, entonces yo creo que, Naomi, hello. Sí, yo creo que es la que... Ah, ok. ¿Hoy sí me escuchas, hija?
Yes, yes.
Ok, perdón, hija linda. Repite tu pregunta.
Are you going to eat for dinner?
For dinner, let's see, today is Thursday, so maybe I'm going to have the traditional Salvadorian food. I'm going to prepare a scrambled eggs. I'm going to fry some beans. Maybe I'm going to fry one plantain. And I don't like bread, so I'm going to have one tortilla, maybe. For drink, I'm going to have water. Yes, water is okay. And you?
Well, I'm going to have a vegetable a subway with cheese for dinner and avocado since my mom ordered that for us, and mm-hmm. I for the drink I have maybe a water.
Okay, thank you. I don't like avocado. I prefer cheese or something like that, or lettuce, but I don't like avocado. Thank you so much, Naomi. Okay, Alessandro, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, Ale, please. Question number one.
Well, for you, what is the school subject do you consider useless?
Ooh, that's a really hard question, because when I was studying high school, the only subject that I liked was language. But the easiest, maybe for me, was physical education. I wasn't an excellent student, but I consider myself as a good student. Not excellent, but good. Why? Because I always said I hate numbers. So I prefer the subjects like science or language or English. So the easiest for me when I was studying high school, maybe the physical education. And you?
Well, for me, the more useless is the physical, no physical sport.
The numbers.
Physical, yeah. That very useless.
Okay, good. Just that? Or is there another one?
Well, yes, I think that's all.
Okay. Okay, thank you. Number two.
What goes to you? What is the more difficult for you to learn English?
The most difficult for me, let's see. Well, not to be difficult, but boring for me, grammar. When I was studying at the university, maybe the boringest part of English was grammar. And now I know it's a very useful skill. But in my opinion, maybe grammar. But actually, I love grammar. But when I was studying, I didn't like it. So I enjoyed the oral presentation. I was always ready for oral presentation. Even that I don't need to study. When I know when I have a good presentation at the university, it wasn't necessary to study for me. Just, okay, give it to me the topic and I'm going to develop in front of the group. I don't have problems to speak in front of people. What about you?
Well, the irregular verbs, that's very difficult. In this moment,
but the problem of the irregular verbs is because changes, right? When you want to pass into past.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, yeah. Till today, I.
Irregular verbs. Most students prefer regular verbs. Is your case?
Yeah. Yes.
Why?
Pero lo que no sé, no me han esperado.
Invent, please. This is a conversation.
Es lo que estoy intentando.
For example, in my case as a teacher, most students have problem with the irregular verbs. They don't like it.
In the conversation. The translate in the conversation in this moment, that's very complicated.
But maybe one reason is you feel nervous?
Yeah, maybe. Well, yes, but that's not all the problem.
Mm-hmm. Is there another one?
Yeah.
Feel confused. In
this, yeah, but in any moment, the other person speak a lot, or the gringos, I speak with the, ¿cuál sería la palabra? With the stranger
words.
Vocabulary. But vocabulary in the school I never
learned. That's okay. Do you receive English classes in your school?
Well, yes, but that I learn more in this.
Okay, thank you. What is the difference?
Well, in the first, the teacher, he speaks in English, but I don't understand when he speaks. Yeah, he speak
very fast or what?
Fast and rarely for me.
Oh, really? Okay. What about homeworks? Are difficult?
Not very easy. Just the star.
Yes. Okay. Maybe my recommendation is just you have to practice. Well, two recommendations. Number one. If you want, you can practice with your sister. Number two, you can watch videos talking about any topic, any conversation in English.
Right, that's, I try to see videos in English. Mm-hmm. I try.
What about music?
I, not always, but usually I speak music in English when the subtitle in English and Spanish.
Ah, okay. Do you understand all?
No, all. For example, the music,
mm-hmm.
The words is that very faster.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, that's it?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, good. Nice conversation. Thank you, Alessandro. Jasmine, but are you ready now?
Yes, yes.
Okay, okay. If you want, please give us your participation and then you can do your appointment. Su mandado, como dicen los salvadoreños. Como que yo no fuera okay, salvadoreña. Como,
sorry, como... teacher.
Okay, Jasmine, please.
Me acaba de surgir.
Okay, bye. No se preocupe. Okay, question one.
Okay, whatever question, okay, no?
Yes, whatever you want. No me vayas okay, a salir con what is your favorite.
Nothing ¿cuál? Personal.
Okay, okay, good. That is going to be a good question. Okay, go.
No. Teacher, what's your opinion about the Thanksgiving Day?
Thanksgiving Day, I love it.
Thanksgiving.
Yes, I love this tradition. It is a shame, es una lástima, it is a shame that we don't celebrate in El Salvador. Mm-hmm. But I remember when I was studying at the university, I did a role play to was a kind of a scene. Fue una pequeña escena que hicimos, a very short scene. So celebrating the Thanksgiving Day. So in my opinion, all days we had to thank God, right? Not just on November. But in this case, it's one of my favorite American celebrations. What's your opinion about that?
Okay, me too, teacher.
It's on November, right?
Yes, November is
the last
weekend of November.
Ah, okay.
25, 26.
Ah, okay. Oh, good.
Mm-hmm. Yes, the date is my favorite celebration of the North America.
Mm-hmm.
And
do you celebrate in your family here in El Salvador?
I working. Yo estuve trabajando. I was working in the kinder, in the American kinder.
Ah.
And
Always celebrate.
Yes, yes. Hacíamos un acto. This is
a role play.
A role play with the children about the Thanksgiving Day.
Oh, good. With turkeys, mm-hmm. pumpkin pies, yeah. Pumpkin.
Only turkey, only traditional America.
What about the food? Do you prepare any food?
I love the turkey.
But in this case, I'm talking about when you were working in the kindergarten, did you prepare any food or just decorate?
Just decorate.
Ah, okay. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yes, Thanksgiving is a really good celebration. I don't like Halloween. And you?
No, I don't like.
Yes,
I prefer
don't like.
Thanksgiving Day.
Yes, and Christmas, right?
Yeah, Christmas is a...
It's a big celebration. Christmas is coming. Oh my goodness. Yeah. Christmas is coming. Do you have plans for Christmas?
I decorate my house.
Mm-hmm.
A tree, bowls.
What do you cook for Christmas?
Chicken.
Oh, okay.
Chicken.
Uh-huh.
Breast of chickens.
Do you prefer chicken or turkey?
Ambos are
both.
Both.
I don't like no one. No one. In my case, my mom prepared both chicken and Kentucky, but I always order a pizza. I don't like turkey. Oh. And talking about chicken, just pollo campero. But the rest, I don't like. I don't like chicken soup. No. I don't like fried chicken. I don't like roast chicken. I don't like it. So I,
in my case, chicken, pretzel, chickens, or a turkey.
Or turkey. Oh, okay. Thank you. Question number two.
Okay, number two. For what you are teacher?
Ooh, the reason is when I was a little girl, one of my favorite games was imagine like, okay, I'm a teacher. I put all my Barbies and teddy bears and I said, okay, class, I'm going to start. The topic is, but I didn't realize to be an English teacher. I say, okay, I want to be a teacher, but I didn't realize to be an English teacher because when I was in high school, Jasmine, I hate English. I hate it because I have a teacher and he always teaches the verb to be all the year, the verb to be. So I didn't learn anything. I didn't remember that I got an oral presentation or, for example, to participate in class, just to work the book, just to work in the book and just that. But I decided to be an English teacher, number one, because English is a necessity right now. So I decided to be a teacher who likes to teach others, number one. Number two, I decided to be an English teacher because today is a necessity. And number three, I don't know, maybe I have the vocation, I don't know, but I love to meet new people. I don't have problem to meet new people. So to be a teacher, when you say, okay, I'm going to be a teacher, you have to be not shy. You have to have a lot of passion and you have to be very confident with your students. So you have to make your students feel comfortable in class. So that's the reason. And you, which career do you study?
Okay. I started in the university with the idea of being a teacher.
Children.
Teacher, not
to teach kids,
not teenage,
not teenagers. That's the opposite. That's the opposite to me because I don't like to teach kids because when you teach kids, you are a second mom. So I don't have patience with kids. I prefer teenagers or adults.
Oh no, I prefer children or kids. I hope to finish one day my university and apply my school.
How many years were you studying?
Possibly 3 years with my thesis.
Where? Oh,
two years.
Where?
In a Tecnológica University.
Ah, okay. Hey, but you can continue. Yes. Yeah, and I think you had the vocation because you always feel happy.
Yes, next year, I hope
God first. Yes, do it. Yes, do it. Yes, do it. I hope you are going to do it, okay? Okay. And English teacher or what?
English teacher. Yeah.
Oh, wow. That is a good option. Excellent. Congratulations. I hope you are going to do it. Yes. You are a very intelligent woman. And you have a lot of patience.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jasmine. Okay. Thank you. You can leave the class.
I love teacher.
Okay. I love you too. Bye, Jasmine. Good night. God bless you. Okay. Excuse me. I'm going to continue with the last student. In this case, Nere, ayúdenme a elegir a la siguiente por si no tengo voluntario. Daniela. Yes, Berito.
Como dijo voluntario.
Sí, pero no, yo digo los que no han participado. Tú fuiste la primera. Ah, ok. Ok. Está Berito y con todo va. Quiero ver, Dani. Ready, tengo Dani, Valeria, solo ellas dos. Por el tiempo vamos a elegir solo a una. Neri, está en sus manos.
Dani.
Ok, thank you. Dani, hello, contigo termino. Ya no te preocupes que lo más que me va a tardar es un minuto y medio. Okay. Hi, Dani, good evening.
Hi, teacher.
Hombre, teacher, casi me duermo aquí escuchando todo. Dani, okay. Are you ready to ask and give us the question?
Yes.
Okay, please. Question one.
Okay. Do you have
Stop.
A favorite?
Vamos a hacer una dinámica diferente, fíjate. Okay. Valeria, activemos micrófono. La pregunta se la vas a hacer a Valeria. Y van a tener una conversación. Vale, es muy buena. Okay, hi, Vale.
Hi, teacher.
Are you ready?
Yes,
almost sleepy. Okay, Dani, excuse me. Okay, señorita, las dejo ahí solitas. 3, 2, action.
Okay. Do you have a favorite song and why?
Yes, I have. Well, in this moment, I have one favorite, and I like it so much because the song is Well, I make me feel so relaxing, and the name is, well, if I don't have a mistake, it's a rock and melody. It is the same. Well, it is the Kaliuchi. I don't know if you hear about she.
No, but can you repeat the name of the song, please?
Different song, or I can, or
repeat you the want, name.
I
no.
say,
repeat the name. Song. The name, the single
well,
name,
Kali Uchi. Yeah, Kali Uchi.
Well, I haven't heard any of their songs, but I have heard of him or, well, of that person because I don't know him. Or hair. So no, I don't.
But you know about. Well, it is not the most recognized. I don't know if that. But you know about Lana Del Rey. Do you like it?
Oh yes. I know her. I know Lana Del Rey.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, she's good.
Do you have a favorite song in this moment, or I don't know, do you like it all?
Well, I have a lot of songs that I like, like many, but I have some of them. For example, I like the song I Didn't Change My Number. Other one is Wake Up in the Sky or Rimstone Eyes. Like the songs, I really like it because it's like makes me feel comfortable and makes me feel happy because the song are like beautiful to hear. So yes, that.
Do you like the band or band about rock and roll or is I don't know. Do you like it?
Well, no, I don't listen a lot of bands of rock and roll, actually.
Me too. I don't like it too much. I don't know. Just I don't like it.
I prefer other songs. For example, R&B or pop, maybe.
Yes, also me too. Like I prefer. Well, I like it too much the old music, but in English. And maybe the that seventh or seven I don't know, is that 70s or maybe
70s.
But when I 70 or when it's about rap, but the old rap.
Oh yeah, it's good.
Danny, question like number it? Two.
Okay. What is your favorite kind of music?
Well, I don't have a favorite one specifically, but because I like it about all, and I like it too much. Maybe if I want to choose one, I can say pop or maybe rap, but when it's American.
Oh, okay.
And do you have a favorite kind of music, or I don't know about you?
Well, yes, I'm not sure if they're my favorite, but it's the kind of music that I usually listen. For example, like I said before, R&B, rap, hip hop, and pop. They're my favorites.
Oh, excellent. Thank you so much, ladies. Okay, my dearest student, we are going to continue and finish with the next review, that is the past continuous. I love this topic because this topic is one of the easiest about grammar, because you need only to recognize when will you use was and when do we use were. For example, I was playing. The question is, what were you doing yesterday? ¿Qué estuviste haciendo ayer? Ah, I was playing. What were you doing yesterday? Ah, I was cooking at home. What were you doing yesterday? Ah, I was preparing my classes. What were you doing yesterday? Ah, I was visiting my uncle. So, past continuous, we use was for I was, he was, she was, it was. We use were for plurals. You were, we were, you were, and they were. For example, what was your sister doing? Ah, my sister was playing basketball. What was your brother doing yesterday in the morning? Ah, my brother was studying for his test. What was your mom doing yesterday at night? Ah, she was cooking the dinner. So that is the past continuous. And the negative is wasn't, weren't, according, it depends on the subject. And interrogative, you remember, because this is a review, we use the verb at the beginning. I was playing in a question. Was I playing? You were playing in a question. Were you playing? So my next example in this case is this one. Number one, can you please, Neri, me ayuda a leer la pregunta, por favor? Thank you.
What were you doing? Perdón, what were you doing last Tuesday morning?
Okay, what were you doing last Tuesday morning? My example is, can you please, Valeria, help me to read last Monday?
Last Tuesday morning, I was visiting my grandma with my siblings. Then at 10 o'clock a.m., my family, and I went to the church. At 12 o'clock, I was preparing the lunch. I cooked a delicious beef, some beans, and white rice. Finally, in the evenings, I was taking my English class. We were studying the past continuous, and I was going to bed at 8:30 p.m.
Okay, thank you, Vale. Thank you, Neri. Okay, if you see, I mixed the past continuous and I mixed with the simple past. Utilicé dos tiempos acá, siempre en pasado. I was visiting, I cook.
pasado continuous, pasado simple. Si usted se fija, por ejemplo, aquí, last Tuesday, yo le puse Monday, last Tuesday morning. Last Tuesday morning, I was, y el verbo siguiente va con ing. I was visiting my grandma with my siblings. Then at 10 a.m., and my family and I went to the church. At 12 o'clock, I was preparing. Yo estuve preparando ¿el qué? El almuerzo. I cook. Yo cociné a delicious beef, some biggies, and white rice. Finalmente, finally. Hay muchos alumnos que me dicen, dan su explicación y me dicen, finally. Y yo me quedo esperando porque finally no significa que usted ya terminó. Finally significa que hace una pausa ya para terminar. Finalmente, eso significa finally. Entonces, a veces el alumno me dice, ok, teacher, finally. Y yo, ajá, finally in what? Continue. So, finalmente, en la tarde, in the beginning, I was taking, estuve tomando mis clases. Para, en este caso, se puede utilizar el verbo take. Estuve tomando mis clases. Hay uno que me dice, I was receiving. Sí, pero me estás pensando en español. I was taking my English class. So, the question number one is, I'm going to start with you, Daniela. Se prepara Neri. Recuerde que pueden inventar. Dani, what were you doing last Tuesday morning? Thank you, Dani. Are you ready or not? Busy or not? Alessandro, please, can you tell to your sister if she's ready or not?
All right, give me a second.
Okay, thank you. Okay, Neri, I'm going to start with you. Second, Daniela. Neri, in your opinion, what were you doing last Tuesday morning? ¿Qué estuvo haciendo el martes pasado?
Last Tuesday morning, I was running in the park.
Mm-hmm.
I was taking my English class in the night.
Mm-hmm. Ahí podemos utilizar and then y luego. Como para ir haciendo una pausa, ¿verdad? And then.
And then I preparing my delicious dinner.
Ahí podemos utilizar pasado continuous. I was preparing o de un okay. solo. El pasado simple. I prepared. I cook. Exacto.
Okay. I was preparing my dinner. And finally,
mm-hmm.
I watched TV.
Okay. I was watching TV.
Pero, teacher, una pregunta, también se puede decir que porque saw es como vi, ¿se puede utilizar o no se puede utilizar?
Lo que pasa es que en este caso saw es cuando usted ve algo, por ejemplo, I saw an airplane, vi un avión. Para la televisión se utiliza watch. Hay gente que utiliza saw, de hecho hay algunos libros que lo ponen como saw, I saw the television. Pero si yo pongo I saw the television, es como que yo digo, ahí está la televisión y yo la vi. Pero no la encendí.
Ok, pero sí, gracias porque ya esa duda ya la tengo.
Ajá. El I saw es cuando yo veo, I saw my sister yesterday.
Ajá, esa.
Yes. Ajá, okay. I saw my best friend in the cafeteria. I watch television.
Ok.
Ok, thank you, Neri.
Thank you, teacher.
Dani, ready or not?
Yes.
Ok, hey, what happened with you, Dani?
Es que se me fue el internet por un momento. No,
ah,
no
ok.
Muy bien.
Ok, don't
Estamos
worry about
la pregunta, ¿cierto?
Yes, yes. Number one, invent. What were you doing last Tuesday morning?
Last Tuesday morning, I didn't do a lot of things. Mm-hmm. First of all, I got up at 6:40 a.m. And I take my breakfast.
Mm-hmm.
Then at 7:10 a.m. I have my online classes. And the online classes finish at 1:35 p.m. Mm-hmm. After that, I ate my lunch. After that, I did some homeworks and watched some series and movies. Then at 7 p.m., I was taking my English classes.
Mm-hmm.
And finally, I was going to bed at 9 p.m.
Okay.
Yeah, finished.
Okay, but you were confused. The question was morning. You say all day.
Oh my God.
Okay, no, no, I'm kidding. Don't worry about that. The question is to be more specific in the morning. Okay, no, that is good. That is good. Okay, voy a terminar con esa pregunta. Obviamente usted la va a contestar y se va saliendo de clases. Es la misma pregunta, solo uno que cambia es el día y la hora. What were you doing last Saturday afternoon? Le voy a dar mi ejemplo en lo que usted piensa el suyo y voy a iniciar con voluntarios. Ojo, no me digan lo que hizo. Ok, thank you. Inicio con Alessandra entonces. No me vaya a decir todo lo que hizo en el día. Solo quiero qué hizo en la tarde. Utilizando el past continuous o el simple past. Mi ejemplo es, last Saturday afternoon, I was doing household chores. Esos son los quehaceres del hogar. Household chores. Por ejemplo, like mopping, trapeando, cleaning my room, limpiando mi habitación, washing my car, lavando mi auto, doing the laundry, lavando la ropa, and watering the flowers. Y regando las flores. At 6 o'clock, obviamente p.m., I was talking with my brother in USA. We talk, utilicé el pasado simple, we talk for 1 hour. And at the end of the day, I was watching a movie with my family. Alessandro, inicio contigo. What were you doing last Saturday afternoon?
Well, the afternoon, I went to the school to take a graduation photo with all my classmates and mm-hmm. teacher.
Mm-hmm.
Later, with any friend, got to eat buffalo wings.
Mm-hmm.
And later, I went to the gym. And finally, I went to the house with my family. Yeah.
Okay. That's it?
Yeah, that's it.
Thank you, Alessandro. Good night. See you next week.
See you.
Volunteer.
Teacher.
Okay, Berito, go ahead. What were you doing last Saturday? Okay, Vale, number two. What were you doing last Saturday afternoon?
Last Saturday afternoon, I was the laundry and wearing the flowers and walk in the park my dog.
With my dog,
and shopping supermarket, for example, with rice, meat, vegetable, cheese, cream, pepper. At 7 o'clock, I was watching the movies in YouTube. Prepared dinner, beans, eggs, bread, and coffee. 8 p.m. I sleep. Finish.
I went to sleep.
I went to sleep.
I went to sleep.
I went to sleep.
Thank you, Berito. See you.
See you.
Okay, see you, Vale. Teacher. What were you doing last Saturday afternoon?
Okay, well, the last Saturday afternoon, well, I remember that I was at my house and I helped my mother. Well, I remember that I helped my mother to prepare the lunch, and we made rice and meat, and then I cleaned my room.
I was cleaning.
I cleaned my room.
Oh, okay.
And I took a shower or a bath, and then I went out to the park for a walk, and I returned to my house early at 6 in the afternoon. And it's all.
Okay, thank you, Vale. Good night. See you next week. Volunteer.
Neri.
Neri, excellent. What were you doing last Saturday afternoon?
Last Saturday afternoon, I was watching videos in YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
I was talking with my mother in El Salvador.
Mm-hmm.
I went to the restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
I was dancing very, ooh, very
too much. A lot.
Yeah, very, yes. I went for my bed 1 a.m.
Wow. Okay.
It's finished, teacher.
Okay, finished. Detallito. I was talking with my mom in the El Salvador. No, de un solo. I was talking with my mom in El Salvador. El de okay. El Salvador no va. Ajá. Detallito chiquito nada más.
Okay.
I was talking with my mom in El Salvador. Thank
in
you, Neri.
El Salvador. Okay. Yes. Thank you, teacher. Good night.
Volunteer. Dani. Hazel. Okay, Hazel, go ahead. Hazel number one, Naomi number two. I'm going to finish with Daniela. Hazel, what were you doing last Saturday afternoon? Peguémonos bien al micrófono.
Okay, teacher. I don't last Saturday afternoon. I was cleaning my home, my bedroom. My bedroom. I was doing listening to music. I was visiting my father.
Uh-huh.
I was helping with here I helping with her clothes I
was finally mm-hmm.
At say 6 o'clock 6 p.m. I was preparing my dinner for my sister and me. Mm-hmm. And my mom and my father. That's it.
Excellent. Muy bien. Thank you, Hazel. Nos vemos mañana. Bye. Okay. Dani, ready?
Yes, teacher.
Oh, no, excuse me, Naomi. Naomi.
Okay.
Excuse me, Naomi. Are you ready, Naomi? Yeah. Miren, me estoy comiendo un Takis. Ahorita porque ya prácticamente tenemos la clase. Un taquito de los morados y putas, pero este volado pica, niñas.
Pero son muy ricos, ¿cierto?
Pero sí, pero mira, hija, yo me equivoqué vos y aquí dice hasta fuego, dice la bolsa, mira.
¿Quería comprar otros?
Ajá, yo quería comprar de los que no pican.
Qué triste.
Pero aquí tengo agua, siempre que doy clases tengo agua, pero menos mal que me puse a comer hasta ahorita que Hazel comenzó a hablar. Ok, Naomi, are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Ok, go, please.
Well, in the afternoon, I'm doing a homework. And also, I read a little, and then my mom and I went to visit my grandma. And that's it.
Okay, thank you, Naomi. Nos vemos el martes, hija.
All right, teacher.
Bye. Dani, ready?
Yes.
Okay, what were you doing last Saturday afternoon?
I was at the beauty salon with my mom because my brother was in the school for his prom. So after the beauty salon, my mom bought some hamburgers. So my brother and I, we can eat. So just that.
Hey, ya se graduó tu hermano.
¿Cómo?
Ya se graduó tu hermano.
Se gradúa en octubre. Mm-hmm. Pero la fiesta va a ser en diciembre.
Ay, qué genial. ¿Dónde la van a hacer, hija?
En un hotel. No me acuerdo el nombre, pero va a ser en un hotel.
Qué genial. Qué chivo, ya va a salir de eso. Thank you, Dani. Sí. Nos vemos el martes. Saludos a tus papis.
Okay, adiós, teacher.
Bye.